during the meeting of Justice Bersamin with Deans and Professor, he mentioned that, tawag dito, magtatanong sa penalties eh. No? So, according to Justice Bersamin, he also mentioned Article 64 and 65 of the Revised Penal Code. Alam mo yung 65, hindi pa tinanong sa mga yan eh. Pero we will be compelled to lecture Article 65, no? Wala tayong magagawa. Noong 64, tinatanong sa bar yan, no? He also mentioned the case of People versus Simon, no? And Islam is not non-negotiable according to... So magpapakompute siya, no? And napaka-toxic magpakompute. Ngayon, at dito muna tayo sa People versus Simon. The ponente is Justice Florence Regalado. This is GM number 93028, July 29 at 1994. No? So, there are, no, tawag dito, there are provisions which are connected with the imposition of penalty. No? For example, Article 6 in relation to Article 5051 of the Revised Penal Code. These are penal provisions. Because if the felony is frustrated, applying Article 50 of the Revised Penal Code, you will graduate a penalty 1 degree lower. No? And if the felony is attempted under Article 6, no, of the Code, applying Article 51, you will reduce the penalty 2 degrees lower. So, mga penal provisions po ito. No? Now, at Article 18, 19 of the Revised Penal Code in relation to Article 52, 53, these are penal provisions, no? Because if the accused is an accomplice under Article 18 of the Revised Penal Code applying Article 52, ibababa mo 1 degree lower. No? If he is an accessory under Article 19 of the Revised Penal Code, no? Applying Article 53, you will graduate the penalty 2 degrees lower. So, mga penal provisions po ito. Now, Article 13, 14, 15, this is mitigating, aggravating, and alternative circumstance in relation to Article 63, 64 of the Revised Penal Code. Mga penal provision po yan eh. For example, if, tawag dito, if the crime committed is homicide under Article 249 of the Revised Penal Code, the penalty is reclusion temporal. If there is an aggravating circumstance, not night time, no? At applying Article 64, you will apply the penalty in its maximum period. So this is a penal provision. Quasi-recidivism under Article 160, this is a special mitigating, aggravating circumstance. Privileged mitigating circumstance of minority under Article 68, no? At tawag dito, organized crime group under Article 62. Mga penal provision po ito, no? Ang tanong, if the offense is punishable under special law, especially if the offense is classified as malum prohibitum, no? Can you apply the penal provision under the Revised Penal Code? No? Yung mga binanggit kong penal provision. No? So this is the case of People versus Simon na binanggit ni Justice Bersamin. Ingatan niyo po ito. Binanggit na ito. Ngayon, kung di siya magtanong dito, edi wow. Pero binanggit niya eh. No? So there are two rules. No? What is the first rule? The first rule is that if the special law adopts the technical nomenclature of the penalty of the Revised Penal Code, the intention is to adopt the penal provision under the code. For example, if the penalty is prison mayor, so that is a penalty borrowed from the Revised Penal Code. So the intention of that special law by prescribing prison mayor is to adopt the penal provision under the Revised Penal Code. For example, in the case of People versus Muntalaba, this is GR number at 186227 at July 20, 2011. The ponente is Justice Peralta. Take note, si Peralta is the best friend of Justice Bersamin. Mag-ano yan eh, sa Quezon City, yung RTC pa sila, magkatabi yung courtroom nila, no? Magkaibigan na magkaibigan niya. In fact, I heard that Justice Peralta helped the promotion of Justice Bersamin to the position of a justice, no? So say justice of the Supreme Court. So, napalagi sila nagkukwentuhan sa mga principles. Mag-ingat po kayo dyan. Pag yung mga pending ni Peralta, you consider that because, no? kasi nga mag-best friend yan. No? So, in the case of people versus Mutalaba, what is involved is, tinanong sa part 2, 2013, ha, ikatan nyo, without reading Mutalaba, yung nag-answer dito. So, the crime committed is illegal possession of dangerous drugs under section 11 of RA 91, 9165. No? The penalty is life imprisonment. The offender is a minor. Ang tanong sa ba, can you appreciate minority under Article 68 no, as a privilege mitigating circumstance? Take two, the penalty is life imprisonment. Yes. Because of section 98 of RA 9165. Under section 98 of RA 9165, the provision of the revised penal code is not applicable unless the offender is a minor. So there are two rules. No? If the offender is an adult, you will not apply the provision of the revised penal code. But if the accused is a minor, you will apply because of section 98. So applying section 98 alone, alam nyo na yung sagot. You can consider the privilege mitigating circumstance of minority under Article 68. Because Article 68 is a provision under the code. And applying Section 98, you will apply the provision under the revised penal code no, of the code. No? If the offender is a minor. No? And, pero dalawa yung reasoning. Dalawa yung reason ni Justice Peralta. Yung pangalawang reason niya is that under Section 98 of RA 9165, no? If the offender is a minor and the penalty is life imprisonment, you will consider life imprisonment as reclusion perpetua. So considering that Section 98 no, adapts the technical nomenclature of the penalty of the revised penal code, that is reclusion perpetua. So the intention is to adapt the penal provision because of the case of People versus Simon, including Article 68 of the revised penal code on privilege mitigating circumstances of minority. So you will reduce reclusion perpetua to reclusion temporal. No. Nakanya yan, People versus Simon. The principle in the case of People versus Simon was affirmed in the case of People versus Musa. No? Now, in the case of People versus Jacobal, no? This is what is involved is illegal possession of unlicensed firearms under the old law. That this is Section 1 of PD 1866, no? As amended by tawag dito, RA 8294, no? Huwag niyo akong masyadong guluhin, ha?
Nakapabidyo ka.
At, so, People versus Jacoba, this is year number 184355, no? At, March 23, no? Kala ko nakalimutan ko na. At, 2015, the ponente is Justice Peralta again. No? So in this case, no? The penalty under Section 1 of PD 1866 is prison correctional in its maximum period. Yung isa naman, prison mayor in its minimum period, depending upon the caliber of the gun. There is a confession. Ang tanong, can you appreciate confession as a mitigating circumstance? No? Now, according to Justice Peralta, as a general rule, if the crime is manu prohibitum, you will not consider confession as a mitigating circumstance. But there is an exception to the rule. What is the exception to the rule? If the special law adopts the technical nomenclature of the penalty of the revised penal code, prison correctional maximum eh. The intention of that law is to adopt the penal provision, including Article 13 on mitigating circumstances of confession in relation to Article 64 of the Revised Penal Code requiring the application of the penalty prescribed by PD 1866 in its minimum period. No? Minimum period. Now, 1985 Bar Examination. Tinanong yan eh, illegal possession of unlicensed firearm under the old law, that is Republic Act No. 4. The penalty is not more than 10 years, not less than 5 years. No? Ang tanong, kayo consider confession as a mitigating circumstance? Nangangawit na siya. No, ang suggested answer, no? Ng UP is that you cannot consider confession because illegal possession of unlicensed firearms is manu prohibitum. That is the old rule. That is the old rule. So, no? So under the old rule, you consider the classification, no, the nature of the crime. If the crime is malum prohibitum, you will not consider confession. If the crime is malum ince, you will consider confession as a mitigating circumstance. That is the old rule. Now, under the present rule, that is the Dakaban principle, no? You will consider that the character of the crime, but the character of the penalty. If the penalty is borrowed from the revised penal code, the intention of that law is to adopt the penal provision under the code, including Article 13, in relation to Article 64 of the revised penal code. Now, if the penalty is not borrowed from the code, so that is a different matter. So you will not consider confession. That is the Dakab. Inaatan niyo yung Dakaban na yan. Now, can you apply the Dakaban principle to dangerous drugs? Depende po. If the offender is an adult, you will not apply. If the offender is a minor, you will apply the Dakaban principle. In fact, even without applying the Dakaban principle, you can rely on Section 98 of RA 9165. If the offender is a minor, you will apply the provision of the revised penal code, including Article 13. Na? Ganun po yan. Now, can you apply the Dakaban principle? No? If what is involved is illegal possession of loose firearms under the present law, this is RA 10591. No? Yes! Because Section 28 of RA 10591 adopts the technical nomenclature of the penalty. Ang penalty po ng illegal possession of loose firearms under the present law, merong prison mayor in its medium period, no? Merong reclusion temporal. No? Now, pag nagbasa kayo, nangangalit ka na ba? Mag-sagit na lang. Now, ipupost ko kasi sa Facebook. Facebook addict ako eh. At, tawag dito. Kung nagbabasa kayo ng mga libro, you will notice that, no? You cannot appreciate quasi-recidivism if what is involved is an offense punishable under special law. Because Article 160 of the Revised Penal Code speaks of a felony. And under Article 3 of the Revised Penal Code, a felony is an act or omission punishable under the Revised Penal Code. So an act or omission punishable under special law is not a felony within the contemplation of Article 3, within the contemplation of Article 160 of the Revised Penal Code. Ang quasi-recidivism is like that. Usually, the one committing that is yung mga nasa bilibid. Kasi if you are a convicted prisoner, you are serving prison in national bilibid, if you commit a crime, you are a quasi-recidivist. Diba? Ang quasi-recidivism is after the finality of the judgment of conviction before serving or during the time that you are serving sentence. No? Alam ba? At kinonvict ka, naging final yung decision mo, tapos nag-issue ng commitment order, no? Dadalhin ka from provincial jail to bilibid. No? Nasa bus ka pa lang, pumatay ka na ng tao, are you required to recidivist? Kasi you're not yet serving sentence, ha? You will serve sentence, no? Pag nabook ka na sa bilibid, ibubook ka as a convicted prisoner. Kasi you have to serve your sentence in national bilibid, not inside the bus station, the bus. E bus yun eh. So you're not serving yung penalty inside the bus, eh kung aircon yun, malamig. You have to serve that in bilibid. So ibubook ka dyan. Yung committed crime, are you required sa recidivist? Before serving or during the time that you're required sa recidivist. Ngayon, tawag rito. Pero ngayon, no, in the case of People versus Salazar, no, this is GM number at tawag dito, 98060 at January 17, 1997, no? January 27 para, I'm sorry, no? I'm sorry. Baka mamaya, sir, mali kayo. Hindi, kinulit ko eh. No, at, so, in the case of People versus, tawag dito, People versus Salazar, what is involved is illegal possession of dangerous drugs under the old law, that this is RA 6425. No? He is a convicted prisoner serving prison in national prison. No, and the penalty, no, for illegal possession of dangerous drugs under RA 6425 as amended by RA 7659, no, is it is borrowed from the revised penal code. No? So the Supreme Court considered quasi-recidivism. Even if this is in Malung prohibitum, so wala na yung mga nababasa nyo sa mga libro nyo. Unlike yung libro kong binasa nyo, no? Kasi ito nag-reflect na yung bagong development sa criminal law, no? At wala na po yun, no? Kasi ina-appraise because of the case of People versus Simon, no? At so sa day, sa present dangerous drugs, kung adult, you will not apply Salazar. Kung minor, yes. Illegal possession, di ba nakukuhanan sila ng mga parel doon? So you will consider quasi-recidivism, no? You will apply the penalty in its maximum period. No? Isa na. Second rule. If the special law did not adopt the technical nomenclature of the penalty of the revised penal code, the intention is not to adopt the penal provision. No? At saka second, if the penalty is not borrowed from the revised penal code, you cannot convict, for example, the penalty is not more than 10 years, not less than 5 years, you cannot convict him of an attempt to commit an offense punishable under special law. No? Why? Because if you will convict the accused of attempted crime, no, and the penalty is not more than 10 years, not less than 5 years, you will be compelled to apply Article 51 of the revised penal code. You will reduce the penalty 2 degrees lower. And what is 2 degrees lower of a penalty of not more than 10 years, not less than 5 years? The penalty is not graduatable. If the penalty is not borrowed from the revised penal code, it is not graduatable. If you make a confession, can you appreciate the mitigating circumstance of confession? If you will do so, you will be compelled to apply Article 64. And under Article 64 of the Code, you will apply the penalty in its minimum period. And what is the minimum period of a penalty of not more than 10 years, not less than 5 years? It is not a divisible penalty. A penalty not borrowed from the revised penal code is not a divisible penalty. So you cannot apply that in its minimum, medium, or maximum period. You cannot apply Article 64 of the revised penal code. For example, Petro versus Santigan Bayan, jail number 111399, no, at November 14, 1994. So what is involved is Section 3E of RA 3019. This is causing undue injury to the government. Tinanong sa Marto, ha? To any party, including the government, through manifest partiality, evident bad faith, gross inexcusable negligence. No? In this case, they are importing toys, but in conspiracy with public officer, they made it appear in the documents that they are importing cassette recorders, but because of a surprise inspection, the government discovered na talagang mga toys. No? Ang intention nila to lower the tax liability. Because of that discovery, they paid the correct tax. So the government did not suffer injury. Chinard sila na attempt to cause undue injury to the government through manifest partiality, evident bad faith. But the penalty for violation of Section 3 is found in Section 9. No? Not more than 15 years, not less than 6 years and 1 month. How can you graduate? No? Since the special law did not adopt the technical nomenclature of the penalty of the code, so the intention of RA 3019 is not to adopt the penal provision. And no, if you will convict him of attempted violation of Section 3E, so you will reduce the penalty 2 degrees lower. What is 2 degrees lower of a penalty of not more than 15 years, not less than 6 years and 1 month? It is not graduatable because it is not borrowed from the revised penal code. No? Tinanong ni Sabar yung confession. No? Malabo yun. No?